Hey everyone, welcome back to Science in Real Life. I'm Molly, and I'm a scientist, and our past episodes have featured some really awesome guest scientists. And you might be wondering at this point how we all came to be awesome scientists. What were our journeys? Are they over yet? How much school do you need to become an awesome scientist? What even are some really cool science career options? So we're going to bring you a special sort of episode today that will hopefully answer some of those questions. We've heard from people with science careers from all over the country. They Skyped in, we interviewed some close by, and we're really excited to share their stories with you. And we're not just going to be talking about careers in science, we're going to be looking at careers across all of STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, and math, because it's all awesome. So we hope you enjoy.
My name is Sophia Prado-Irwin. I'm a first-year graduate student at Harvard University, and I'm a member of the Lossos Lab, and we study the ecology and evolution of Caribbean lizards.
My name is Amy Litt. I'm on the faculty of the University of California at Riverside, and I study the molecular basis of plant evolution and diversity.
Hi, my name is Juliana Canale. I'm currently a food scientist and food safety quality assurance specialist.
Hi, I'm Christina Kramer. I'm the facilities manager at the Department of Biology at New York University.
Hi, my name is Sarah Sinclair, and I'm a senior at Cornell University studying information science, systems, and technology in the College of Engineering. And what I'm passionate about is human-computer interaction design.
I grew up actually in a really rural area. My school did not really have a lot of advanced math and science programs. So how I started was mostly doing a lot of exploration on my own, getting rock collections. It started off as very large rock collections.
I was always interested in biology, even as a child, but my earliest plans were to be a medical doctor. But when I got to college, I had my first opportunity to take classes in ecology and evolution, and they really caught my interest.
I guess that when I first realized that I was really passionate about biology was in high school, actually. I was taking kind of general intro biology course, and just remember being so fascinated by it.
I took our intro to Python course and really fell in love with the coding side of things. That's when I decided technology was what I wanted to do.
I've always had technical curiosity, and I've always questioned everything, and I've always loved being in the kitchen, whether it's baking, whether it's cooking. So when I found out that Cornell University had a food science program that really meshed my two interests of cooking, baking, art, and then figuring out all the chemistry, all the engineering, all the biology, why things work the way that they do in regards to food and food application. That's really kind of how everything came together.
When I got to college is the first time I actually realized it was a career option. I started taking some biology classes for fun and learning about the research that my professors were actually doing in the real world. And that opened my eyes to the fact that there's still so much that needs to be discovered in general about the world, and in particular about reptiles and amphibians, which is sort of my passion.
I got my master's degree in biology. Turns out that it's just not my passion in life, that I'm really interested in science, but I didn't actually want to be doing science, holding the pipettes, writing the grants. Throughout my time while I was working as a technician, I was always really fascinated with how the department was run. So in the beginning of 2011, half of the biology department relocated into a new building. And our director of administration was running around, trying to make sure that everything was in the right places. And I kept asking her, oh, what are you doing? Can I help? What are you doing? Can I help? What are you doing? Finally, she asked me if I would apply for the facilities manager position that they were having a lot of trouble filling. So they took a chance on me and hired me. And since then, I found that I really love it. I'm so happy that I took a chance and made a big change.
As a faculty member at a research university, my job consists of both teaching and research. the best part of my day is almost always working with my students at postdoc. I've always really loved teaching, and this type of one-on-one interaction, watching them grow and mature as scientists, that's really the most exciting part of it for me.
I am the CEO and co-founder of Transcendent Consulting, which is an academic consulting firm dedicated to enriching and enhancing student education in New York City and beyond, developing applied material for kids of all ages so that they have these integrated math and science lessons and see math as more than, you know, kind of a rote subject that they have to get through, and more as, you know, part of the building blocks of science and what allows you to explain how the world works around you.
So as a first year grad student, I'm kind of figuring out what ideas I want to pursue in the future. So a lot of my time right now is spent reading articles, talking to my peers, talking to professors, and figuring out, first of all, what are some open questions in the field that I'm interested in, and what are some possibilities I might be able to pursue. One of my favorite things is that a lot of times I get to go into the field and do work in the wild, essentially. So I've been able to, in the past, go salamander hunting in California, and I've been able to work in Costa Rica catching lizards and taking temperatures, measuring habitat, and things like that. So it's really nice to be able to balance sort of the thinking, sort of heady process that happens in my office or in the lab with going out and really experiencing the natural world, which is a big highlight.
The part of my day-to-day that I really enjoy the most is when I get to solve problems for people who have just started working in the lab, or, you know, who have been here for a couple of years and always wanted to know how something worked, and I can tell them.
I work in a production manufacturing plant, and I have to carry out tasks in a lot of different areas. So it could be walking the production floor, overseeing sanitation and manufacturing employees, the marketing and sales coming to me and being like, look, we want to reduce the sodium levels in some of our products that we're working on. I love my free time. I volunteer at a nonprofit that my friend from Cornell started up. It's called Go Forefront. And we basically have a four-phase approach on supplying water, education, social justice, and medical support to areas that are in underdeveloped countries.
So I was able to work with a team of other students and design a website for a local children's literacy nonprofit, Lansing Loves to Read. I have worked with the ESL teachers at a local high school in order to create an application to facilitate communication between parents and their children's teachers.
One of the really great things about a career in science is that there are so many different types of job opportunities.
So I think a lot of people imagine that getting a PhD leads you into a track of being a professor or a lecturer, which I think is a great option for many people. Potentially that's what I'll do too. But I think I'm sort of a little more interested in conservation. There's a lot of organizations, independent organizations, and government organizations that do work trying to conserve and protect the natural habitat and all of the animals living in it.
One of the places that I'm interested in going is into university administration and really supporting, helping advocate and support science departments.
So I think there is a lot of flexibility to kind of change around and move between careers once you have your STEM degree. It's really about how you think, how you approach problems, how you can solve them. All those skills are just really fantastic to have, and I think position anyone with an engineering degree to go forth into the world and succeed at whatever arena they choose to try their hand at.
There are options, of course, to go into teaching, do middle school teaching, high school teaching, college level teaching. There are just lots and lots of different options. There are options to join other businesses and do academic consulting with other places. It's just the possibilities are kind of endless.
So to anyone who is interested in the field of biology in general, I would say my advice is to just take every opportunity you can to get involved in research early and often, because I think it's a good way to figure out what you personally are interested in, And also what sort of types of biology you might want to pursue. For example, if you're more interested in molecular biology and lab work, or if you're more interested in field work, etc.
You should learn how to program. It doesn't matter what science you're going into, learn how to program at some level. Work hard, it'll pay off. Also make sure you take breaks and you don't overwork yourself. And make sure that you learn how to speak to people, how to relay and disseminate the results from your research, but also just how to, you know, have regular conversations with people.
And really kind of just becoming a sponge and just soaking up anything and everything that you can. So if you have somebody that has a similar interest to you, or you're curious about something, it never hurts to ask a question, to meet face to face, to shoot an email. Everyone in the STEM field, I've learned, has really been helpful and supportive of encouraging younger people to pursue their passion.
The world is full of fascinating questions to answer, and there's all different kinds of ways to answer them. And so that's what really keeps me going, and I think people who have that type of curiosity, science really comes alive for you then.